Another question that comes is, in today's time with digital revolution, internet, cell phones, 4G technology, all of this, do you think, like a lot of aspects that can be taught online, do you think cinema also can be taught online?
Why should we leave cinema out? And surely cinema can be taught online. Though it is a hard thing to get around. Because we all feel that it's a combined activity, it's a joint activity, it's a team activity, and it's completely practical. And that has been the traditional format of teaching cinema anyway. It doesn't fit into the regular university programs, primarily because you cannot have a theory question paper, for example.
Correct.
Beyond a certain point.
Right.
And you cannot have theory classes per se beyond a certain point. It's a point taken. But is it then entirely impossible that this is something which cannot at all be done online? There are aspects of it which perhaps require the physical presence of. Now this of is a blank. Does this mean that it requires the physical presence of a teacher? Because the teacher can be online and still be looking over your shoulder, guiding you in every aspect.
Okay.
Whatever has to be assessed is essentially something which can be exchanged over long distances. It is true that human interaction in close quarters has a different kind of effect. But if you are living in some remote part of the world and you want to gain that knowledge from a person who's on the other part of the world, and either it's too expensive, too improbable, or simply impossible for you to gain it at that distance, then what do? Should that knowledge be denied to you? Or will you deny yourself that chance?
Of course not.
So in ideal condition, probably it might be best that you sit at the feet of your guru and learn whatever you have to learn. But then if the guru is offering you something at a distance with the promise of overlooking whatever you're doing at your end, then if it's not 100%, then perhaps it's a 95% kind of a deal.
Makes sense, yes.
Right. And given the situation, then this 95% could perhaps be 105% also, no? There might be some other factors which take you beyond that.
Right.
It is only right when you are in comparison with that mean, which you think is the standard, the physical education, is when you start thinking of it as something lesser.
True.
But once you get past that hang-up of that physical education is the ideal education, then if you evaluate, perhaps you find that this as an online education of cinema is better than physical education. Let me give you an example. You are a prospective film student. You go to the best film institute in the country. Okay. There'll be a bunch of teachers over there.
Yes.
That are faculty from inside. Then probably there will be some faculty which will be guest faculty. Will be in the close circle, drivable kind of distance. Now and then you might have some kind of workshop with some expert who is outside that domain also.
Right.
What is the guarantee that all these teachers that are inside, these are your captive faculty, are the best in their field, they are the best teachers?
Not necessary. Not necessary at all.
Extends to guest also. It is only the workshop faculty which you are sourcing
experts
from wherever in the world who you really have a choice on.
Correct.
Right? If your education, the daily lectures or the daily theory, the daily practicals was conducted by these same experts, do you think the quality of your education would improve?
Drastically.
So this is only possible if I can run or you can attend a class where the teacher is in New York, in Cuba, in Delhi,
right,
whoever this XYZ person might be. But that choice comes only when you're open to the idea of receiving education online.
That is true.
So the richness of the faculty improves, irrespective of the distance at which you're operating, goes up. So that is one of the advantages. This is one of those things, like few things in life, where the best of the people are practicing. Some of whom are capable of being teachers also.
Right.
Because not all practicing professionals can be teachers. They might be great at what they're doing, but they might not be articulate enough to explain whatever. They might not have the time or patience to teach you also.
True.
So that little subset of people who are both professionally proficient as well as academically sound and have the cherry on the top called articulation, that they can speak and explain, have the patience and the inclination to teach. These people are few worldwide, and therefore sourcing them becomes easier. This whole thing about the college experience, etc., is also centered around the fun that we have. So this friends and masti and, you know, all that other things which surround the actual learning teaching experience is also something very desirable and is part and parcel of the college experience.
True.
So that cannot be delivered online, sure. But that core experience of learning and teaching can surely be delivered online. The problem is that whether the student is diligent and receptive enough, that they will listen to whatever is being said attentively, will they follow up on the assignments as diligently, will they do it in time, etc., etc. If the student promises to do that, then any of it is deliverable online. Ultimately, at the heart of it, it's a solitary exercise. You
yes.
need a bunch of people to execute variety of roles. And if you're going for, if you are aiming for film production, film direction, or the two of them combined as it happens in India, called filmmaking, then these people who you ultimately going to end up shooting with are not your friends from the college. There's going to be a bunch of people around your community in the area where you live.
Right.
So why don't you start sourcing them from day one? You start with a short film, a small film, a microscopic film, which involves nobody. You'll be the cameraman, you'll be the actor, you'll be the editor. But the next film, take a notch up. Get your sister to act. In your next film, get your sister and brother to act. And get a friend to handle the camera.
Right.
So keep looking out to source the right kind of people to make a little community who are going to enable your filmmaking is part of what we are trying to achieve. And if you can achieve that successfully, by the time that one is through with the training, they are in with the team. You already have
Absolutely.
This bunch of people
Absolutely.
Who would extend from zero cost, your friend, your relative, your cousin, etc., to the highest professional. Then it will depend on is it a commission project? Is it a project, a commission I'm basically, mean, a project which is coming in with some money? Or it's a project that you're doing on your own?
On your own.
On your own steam, your own money. So between these two extremes, you will always have these amateurs or professionals who can fill in all these specific roles.
Right.
Point is, do you know what is to be done? Who are these professionals? How do you handle them? What do you do with them? After you have got this bunch of people, how do you make a film? Do you know that part?
Huh.
That part can be taught online.